I cannot tell you what a delight it is to talk to you in person. So many people do Zoom now, but people are starting to trickle in now. And I don't know about you, I miss humanity so much. Not all humanity, because some people are dreadful.
Yes, some people are.
We won't go into names, but you know, let's get into some names.
Yeah.
But I have to say, just having you here, what's it like for you? Because I know that you're someone that for years, you know, in New York City, you're a performer, you love crowds. How are you handling the no crowds aspect of this whole thing?
It's been tough. Yeah, I'm excited to watch us all emerge, you know, as the pandemic nears an end. But you lived in New York for years. I mean, it's so crazy to just go from being so used to being in everyone's personal space to the complete opposite.
Well, you know, I have this experience now. I don't know if you have this, but I'll just be watching TV and movies and people get on subways.
Yeah.
And I think, oh, right.
Remember that?
I used to jump on subways. And that just looks insane
now. Oh, my gosh.
That we would all used to pack into those things?
Fully, just sardines.
Yeah.
In fact, the last, I have a horrifying memory associated with that. The last time I was on a subway in New York pre-pandemic, it was during rush hour.
Yeah.
I got on the subway and just super packed in. I was pressed up against this very tall man who he had his back against the edge of the subway car. And yeah, it was one of those pre-pandemic.
So your face is like pushed into his chest,
just like
kind
fully
of?
Inside his torso, but like no peripheral vision whatsoever because there are people like all up. And I had my AirPods in. I was just like, stay in your lane, be small, and just get through this. I was like 8 stops away from where I was going. And I was just in there. A lot of time had passed. And finally, after like, I was like, I think that's been 8 stops. I just remember peeling out of this man. I mean, I was engulfed by his chest.
Right, like your nose is in his sternum.
Just inside his body, yeah. And no one's moving. It's so intimate, which, again, that's just how it was back pre-pandemic. So I was just so up against his chest, finally peeled out of his body to see if we're at my destination. And no one was in the subway at that point. Like 3 people.
Everyone had cleared out.
Everyone.
Probably a while ago.
Probably. And I'm like, how long was I just inside this man's body for absolutely no reason?
I love the idea. I'm just picturing the completely empty car and he's there and you're just and there's no one.
No one. It's like one lady 20 feet away and I'm just backing out of the subway looking at him like, how could you not tell me? And he was like, haha, that was hilarious.
Yeah.
Just fully
and your,
found it so
your impression
funny.
Is on his chest.
Yes.
You're absolute.
Please save me from myself. Why didn't you tell me?
Well, yes. I can't wait till we get back to having our faces in strangers.
More experiences like
strange
that.
Strange men's chests. Because I enjoyed that as well.